Matt, next question. It says, Matt, you have spoken out about the benefits of innovation in tobacco harm reduction products. How can the UK become the world leaders in harm reduction innovation post-Brexit? That is to say, what would you advise the UK government to do to enable further innovation?
Really good question and right up my alley. The UK pioneered the concept of harm reduction back in the 1980s when it was a question of HIV. The people catching the AIDS virus through contaminated needles, drug addicts, were essentially told in most of the world, you're breaking the law, you're evil people, we're not going to help you, bad luck, you've got a disease. Whereas in Britain, Norman Fowler, as health secretary, said, no, what we should do is we should go and give these people clean needles, hand them out for free. You can't do that. These are drug users, you know. Well, we tried it. We got about 1% HIV infection of heroin users after a period, whereas the equivalent figure in America was something like 30 or 40%. So harm reduction really does work. You know, saying, I want you to do a less dangerous version of what you're doing. It's not safe. Drug use is not safe, but this is less dangerous than doing it without clean needles. The same people who did that were then still in the civil service when vaping came along nearly 20 years later and were influential in the government taking a decision in this country, much more than in any other country, to let vaping flourish. And David Halpern, running the Nudge Unit, was actually very influential here because, thanks to Rory Sutherland, he got the point very early on that this could be a safer form of smoking. And if it could displace smoking, it could save lives, even if it wasn't 100% safe. And he persuaded David Cameron to reject the advice of the public health nannies that this technology should be banned. And as a result, the UK has one of the leading take-ups of vaping and one of the fastest falling rates of lung cancer in the world. The contrast with America is very sharp, where vaping has been officially disapproved of and therefore has gone black market like drinks did in the 1920s under prohibition and has become very unsafe. Whereas in this country, we focus on making sure vaping is safe rather than making sure it's discouraged. There's a constant battle going on here, but Britain really did steal a march on the rest of Europe, on the rest of the world. I mean, vaping is still pretty well illegal in Australia and on America. It was a time of great innovation. Look at the vape shops. Look at the technologies that developed. Look at the ferment of people trying different ways of marketing these devices, the way they changed very rapidly from things that looked like cigarettes to things that didn't, you know, et cetera, et cetera. It was a really interesting case history of innovation, and it was a lifesaver for a lot of people. The fact that it may not be 100% safe means that the Daily Mail will constantly be tiresome on the subject. But it doesn't mean that it's not saving lives. It's saving lives on a huge scale.